A lot of you beginning and intermediate lifters out there are confused, and it's not your fault. The fault lies with the people on the other side of the camera lens. Let's look at some of the reasons why there is so much conflicting information and why you're confused. It's not because you're stupid, it's because you can't possibly make sense of all the garbage being thrown your way. Four reasons that there's garbage being thrown your way and it's so confusing. The first is that there's idiots masquerading as experts. I'm not gonna name any names here, but this pretty boy, it was 19 and he has a well-known egg named after him that has 4 grams of carbs. I went to his website once and I laughed hysterically. He was selling these workout programs for, I don't know, $300, $400, that claimed to give his lifetime's worth of experience. He's 19! So anyway, that's the first problem. Idiots masquerading as experts. You know, they take a weekend class, they think they're an expert. And of course, it's like, they can't admit they're wrong. They just make shit up. So that's the first problem. The second class of people causing the problem are scam artists who are just trying to maneuver you into buying their shit. They might be selling supplements, they might be selling some overpriced workout program, but the information they're giving you is intentionally misleading so that you're forced to buy their stuff or encouraged to buy their stuff. So those are kind of devious. But there's two ways that trainers can confuse you where they're not really intending to. The third problem is when trainers on YouTube make assumptions about your goals and your limitations that are not true. They don't realize that there's a wide audience out there and not all of them have the same goals. You can't say this is the best way to bench press unless you're talking about, are you trying to maximize muscle mass gain? Are you trying to maximize strength gain? So a lot of trainers make these unqualified statements about a certain method being best without saying what the goal is. So of course, people are gonna get confused. The fourth problem is one that I try really hard to avoid, but even I forget sometimes. It's you have to be careful who your audience is, because advice that is really good for beginners is really horrible for advanced lifters and vice versa. I try to say when each is the case, but sometimes even I forget. So this is a great example. I've done some videos in the past where it's the free form workout where you do something completely different. And these can be awesome for advanced bodybuilders, because for advanced bodybuilders, a lot of times they get in this rut. They're doing this, they know their workout routine by heart, and they're in such ruts that if they get to the gym and the bench press isn't available, they go into a tizzy because they can't possibly change their workout. These are the people for whom it is a great idea to mix up their workout and do something like this pool workout that I'm showing here. On the other hand, beginners need to stick to a well-established workout program. It can be a strength training type program like Starting Strength or 5x5, or it can be a bodybuilding 3-day-a-work kind of program like is on my website for home workouts, or the 3-day-a-week bodybuilding workout for gyms that's on my website, or any other standard workout done without modification. The problem is beginning bodybuilders always think they can improve upon workouts, but they always screw them up 99% of the time, because if you ask a beginner what their weak body parts are, they're gonna say pecs and arms. That's all they want to work out is pecs and arms. They need to stick to a standard workout. So for them, a free form workout like this pool workout I'm doing now is a really bad idea. They need to stick to the plan. Advanced lifters need to get out of their rut. So different strategies for different kind of lifters. Now, in this case, I had no time to go to a gym. I had no time to go work out in my home gym. I was getting this property ready for the new occupants, and my only choice was to do a workout then and there in the 1 hour free I had that afternoon. So for me, it was an awesome workout, a great chance to mix things up and have a great, an invigorating workout. It was really fun. Was it a balanced workout? No, but it was awesome. All kinds of different angles and different positions, a lot of creative band stuff. It was a great workout. So I hope this helps clarify a little bit why there's so much conflicting information on the internet, and also how you have to be really careful when you get advice to know who that advice is directed toward and what the goal is. Always ask questions. If someone tells you that high reps are for toning and low reps are for gaining strength, you better do a pillow scream. For me, do a pillow scream. Because I had a very limited time in this pool workout, everything was supersets. There was no resting whatsoever. I would choose 3 exercises and then do them round robin without rest between them for about 15 or 20 minutes and then move on to the next superset. So in this first one, I start off with push-ups. Do as many as I can, do them to failure, slow, very deliberate form, and then using a heavy resistance band, I work out the triceps, doing one arm at a time. Again, trying to pin the elbow in space to my ear instead of having the elbow wandering so that it only works the tricep. And then do the other arm. And then as kind of a rest, I do crunches to get ready, because after doing the triceps, push-ups require a lot of tricep too. So the crunches are actually giving me a chance, my triceps a chance to rest so that they're fresh for the push-ups 45 seconds later. So that's the first superset. Push-ups, triceps with the band, and crunches. The second superset was interesting. It only had 2 exercises, mainly because I'm working out 1 pec at a time. So I'm doing band flies, doing 1 pec at a time, then do the other side, and then I'm doing the same exercise for triceps again. So this is just doing pecs and triceps. So I just go back and forth, 1 pec, other pec, tricep, tricep. Did that for like 10 or 15 minutes. So that was the second superset. Because I was getting warm, the third superset involved the pool. So what I would do is as many push-ups as I could do to failure, nice slow form again, and then jump in the pool quickly to cool off, come back, do crunches, turn over, do push-ups, go back in the pool. So that was the third superset. 2 exercises with a splash in between. Again, this was about having fun. My fourth and final superset had 3 exercises in it. The first was band flies. I used a little creativity to find 2 mounting places for the bands. Even though the bands were of dissimilar size, that was okay. It all works out. I just swapped sides every other set. So the first exercises, band flies. Then I would go and do narrow grip push-ups, and then I would do as many as I could of those to failure. Then again, I do the crunches as rest. The reason the crunches are better for rest than texting is that when you're texting, the time gets away from you, and you know, 10 minutes later you realize, oh, you're supposed to be lifting. But when your rest is doing crunches, you get anxious really soon to get back to the lifting. So it keeps the workout on track when you do crunches for your rest. So that was the fourth and final superset in my pool workout. Again, this is only appropriate for advanced bodybuilders who are stuck in their ways and need to mix things up. A workout like this is not something I would recommend for a beginner or intermediate because they need to stick to standard workout programs completely unmodified for the first 2 or 3 years. That is it for today. Thanks for watching. Auf Wiedersehen.